Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Harlequin, and today I've got a great game for you between ProPipe and Stefanhaines. ProPipe is a top 1% airborne player, and he's going to be spawning in the upper right-hand corner, and going right into a normal sort of allied airborne infantry build order, which is just grabbing a barracks right off the bat with his very first set of engineers. Meanwhile, Stefanhaines is a favorite player of mine. This is him playing as his defensive access account right now, and he's doing also a standard build order that I've seen him do many times, which is that he opens with both of his beginning pioneers, sends them off to different cap points, and then spawns his hero pioneers, which are these construction pioneers right here. Again, anyone new to Company of Heroes Online, you have heroes that you can level up and they retain levels between games. So construction pioneers happen to be really good at building buildings. So having them out as the third pioneers building the warmout quarters makes a ton of sense. So getting back here to our friend ProPipe. Like I was saying, both of these players are top 1% players on the ladder. In fact, I believe at the time that this game was recorded, ProPipe was maybe rank 1 or 2 for the allied players. So we're going to get a good look at exactly what top play looks like at this stage of the open beta for Company of Heroes Online. And if you guys haven't played it yet, go to www.companyofheroesonline.com. I got to add that part there too. Free to play, open beta. Go check it out. So we're going to take a look at the tactical map right now and just get a good overhead view of what's going on and at least see what our allied player is doing here. So you can see that he's just kind of moving around. This map has got some unique disadvantages, which is that at least from the south side, everything is kind of choked off at these two bridges, whereas from the north side, you've kind of got this wide open field to work with, and then you do have a sort of a bridge and sort of a hedgerow on this side here. So you sort of had the same effect top to bottom, but honestly, I think the top is a little bit more open. So right off the bat, let's take a look and see what kind of units we've got coming out here. We've got some infantry moving out, and here we go, the Gladiator Riflemen. So ProPipe is no chump, and he knows that these are some of the best units in the game right now. Gladiator Riflemen is basically a purple epic quality, if you will, hero. They're very rare. You can only get them through drops and that sort of thing, and he has leveled them all the way to level 5. They're very tough, very accurate. They can throw hand grenades and sticky bombs, and they have elite armor. But we'll check out a few more things with Stefan at the moment. So his bargain Volksgrenadiers were his first unit that he had out. Again, this is another very rare item, but their main advantage is cost. They're actually much cheaper, and they're worse than regular Volksgrenadiers at first, and as you level them, they get back to normal. So really, they're just very cheap and allows you to produce quickly. So Volksgrenadiers versus Engineers, not going to be a good fight here for the Engineers. They're going to have to get out or hide in the building. This is a great stall tactic. Always a wonderful stall tactic. Wait for the Gladiator Riflemen to come up and bail you out, and that's exactly what's going on. And looks like Stefan's going to have to kind of reposition himself here, because these Gladiator Riflemen pack a punch. In general, Allied Riflemen are a lot better than Volksgrenadiers, at least at first, and especially once they get a few upgrades. But the Gladiator Riflemen especially so. So we're just going to kind of see a standoff here for the meantime. Looks like these Engineers have been evacuated from the building, but he hasn't quite decided what to do with them yet. I kind of want to see them take this fuel. But there's a lot going on here. You can see that down here we've got another little skirmish about to happen. But this is just escalating here. We've got a second group of riflemen here taking cover behind the hedgerow. You can see by my mouse cursor these little yellow dots on the ground indicate that this is medium cover, which is pretty good, whereas it's hard to tell exactly what the Volksgrenadiers have. I'm guessing it's approximately medium as well. And here comes the charge. So we've got the all the Allied Riflemen rushing up against the Volksgrenadiers, and it looks like they just have the advantage in numbers and are just going to inflict some major casualties. Already we see one group retreating, and the second group is also retreating. So ProPipe has kind of won this battle. His Engineers are back in the building. He's going to come back here and pick off some of these Pioneers. But you'll see that Stefan is being very aggressive with his Pioneers. He's making sure that he's just constantly capping in the back. There was a tiny little skirmish down here, and it looked like that ProPipe's Engineers got the advantage with a little bit of cover. You can see there's a body here. He kind of fought from behind this and forced this one Engineer to retreat, which is pretty good. For anyone, again, who isn't too familiar with the way this works, you kind of spend most of the early game capping these points, which up the amount of resources that you get. You can see right now that the numbers on the left are the current resources. The numbers on the right are the amount of resources per minute. So 10 fuel per minute, whereas he has 59 total. As you cap more fuel points, you get more fuel per minute, that sort of thing. So pretty much that's what they're doing right now, is just fighting over the initial fuel caps. And what is typical in these games is that players don't play a lot of attention, at least at a high level, to these victory points. As one player controls more of the victory points than the other, which is the case right now for ProPipe, you can see ProPipe has 500 points, and he's causing Stefan to tick away. So Stefan has fallen from 500 down to 437. Stefan really needs to cap this one. It's not that important at first. And here comes Stefan's Fatherland HMG team, which is another level 5 hero. And these guys are really awesome. Whereas the Bargain Volksgrenadiers were much more of kind of an effective economic choice early game, the Fatherland HMG team has huge range, great suppression power, really just wonderful damage. And most German games early on rely on this unit really just kind of holding back the Allied infantry. So we're going to take a look around here in the middle a bit. We've got the Gladiator Rifleman capping this point. Meanwhile, we have a strong surge coming here on the south by ProPipe. And this is really where ProPipe is being very smart about his map control. He's making sure this is normally generally considered like all of this area is the Axis territory. You know, it's on his side of the map. But he's being really aggressive and pressing all the way in here, knowing that it's probably not well defended, and actually inflicting some heavy casualties on these engineers. So he's going to just force Stefan to have to come here and cap all this territory, including these precious fuel depots. And that's what everybody really wants early game, because they all want to rush for vehicles later. So we've got the Gladiator Rifleman here, still pretty much holding this flank entirely by themselves. If you just kind of look at the map a little bit, he's, you know, this is the only unit here for him. I think these are some engineers. Nope, some riflemen up above. But really, they're just kind of keeping the fight alive, chasing away this HMD team. They're not actually retreating yet, they're just kind of running. But Stefan's going to be very careful with these guys, but it looks like these Gladiator Riflemen might be getting a little overextended, what with all of these infantry right above them. Going to take a quick peek down below here just to see what's going on. It looks like we've got a few more Riflemen here. Two whole squads of them. And like I said, he's capped all the way down into Stefan's territory. So ProPipe is doing a great job. A little bit of a skirmish here. It looks like Stefan went ahead and used one of his entrenched position abilities to give these guys a little bit extra defense, but was not enough. ProPipe won by just 2 units there, very wounded, but here comes Stefan capping this whole area, and the HMG team looks like it opened fire. Oh, these are probably losses to the Gladiator Rifleman. Yes, and they are retreating right here, so it looks like they were able to come back and hold that position on the bridge for a little bit here. So still kind of going back and forth, but again, he's really trying to distract Stefan and force him to defend this area. And this is a lot of riflemen. This is way more riflemen than any of these can hold. These construction pioneers, good at building, not too much good at anything else, honestly. They can sprint around, and that's about it. So, but at the same time, you know, he kind of lost control of the north half of the map. So you see this kind of interesting split on the map right now, where it's kind of left and right sides, and really the map doesn't naturally divide that way. So again, you can see Stefan technically owns both of these victory points, but he hasn't capped either of them yet. And normally I really like the fact that he would rather do damage to the enemy, but at this point he's actually really low at 350 points. He kind of needs to make sure that he stops bleeding out, which is exactly what this has done since the score is tied 1-1. Meanwhile, this Fatherland HMG team has moved up and has scared off the first group of riflemen, the second group taking cover behind this hedgerow here. A little bit more footsie going on. Like I said, sort of like how in StarCraft or other games you've got micro and macro to worry about. In this game, you kind of, your micro and macro, your macro is more about the overall chessboard of regions that you want to capture, like stuff like this going on up here in the north and who wants to fight over what, whereas your micro is what you're doing in each particular game. So every player has to constantly think about this chessboard and which positions they can cap and which positions they're at risk of losing. Like right now, infantry doing a big push here down the center and absolutely scaring away. And look at that! Oh, I don't know if we saw this little detail here. There was a mine placed in the ground. ProPipe saw it and he threw a hand grenade on it just to set it off. Wasted a hand grenade, but you know, he didn't have time to get minesweepers, or he didn't want to take a casualty. Just throw a hand grenade on it, why not? And so here we see our first scout plane on the left. I believe that is a free ability once you level it as a airborne commander. So he's being really good about taking inventory of the enemy. And now we see these riflemen down south here are in a little bit of trouble, because now they are actually outnumbered enough that they might be at risk. They're just going to take a defensive position here and try and stall. Meanwhile, these pioneers, the construction pioneers, are looking just to cap. So we've got the Bark and Volks Grenadiers up here, finally coming back up, trying to recap this ammunition point. More infantry coming back. Looks like the Gladiator has resupplied. And the Rifleman here just kind of defending this point, trying to inflict a little bit of casualties here. Meanwhile, infantry coming in and having a very close fight with a bunch of Volksgrenadiers. And as you can see by this green cover icon, these little green dots, this whole area here is heavy cover. So this is kind of indecisive. But meanwhile, it looks like Stefan has gone ahead and activated his entrenched positions, which is what this green map indicates here. They have increased accuracy and armor. But yet, even with that extra armor and accuracy, it looks like it's getting really close. Who's going to win this? We've got Bars. These are Vet 1 riflemen with Bars, which is the Browning automatic rifle. Very good against infantry. A single Volksgrenadier left, and he's retreating. Look at that. Two riflemen left, one Volksgrenadier left. Meanwhile, we got the same fight going on down here. Once again, these infantry who were kind of entrenched here all by themselves are finally getting resupplied by these Gladiator riflemen who, oh, even take out the rest of that engineer crew over there. So once again, it looks like ProTip is in control of the south side of the map. Meanwhile, Stefan desperately needs to cap these points. It's been uncapped, but he still hasn't quite won it yet. It looks like his second group of Volksgrenadiers came up here, killed the rest of these riflemen who were very wounded, and even picked up their Browning automatic rifle, as indicated by this little graphic down here. Meanwhile, finally we see this a flank coming from the north, basically. Whatever that means, if that's a flank or not, but he's finally trying to recap some of his northern positions. Single infantry squad and slightly wounded engineers with a flamethrower. More Volksgrenadiers moving along here. And we've got reactive artillery on this point. Stefan knows he can't lose this point, if you notice. Actually, I guess that wouldn't quite divide his territory yet, but still, that's a very key intersection. So he instantly reactive artilleries at any units inside that circle. Run the risk of getting hit by, I think it's about 3 artillery shots. And they're retreating, which is the right move. And now here we see the advantage of the airborne player. Here come the the first group of airborne, and you can see right now they're researching the recoilless rifle, I believe, which is a great anti-vehicle weapon because they know what's in store for them. They know this is the timing of the game, whereas you can see Stefan has already got his Sturm Armory up. Meanwhile, we look back at the Allied players to get a look at their build orders. Not much here in terms of build orders. A little bit of recon going on here still. Not too many other abilities being used at this point. Big group of units here with the Fatherland HMD is really about to keep all of these guys pinned. They're going to have to back out. We have upgraded to, looks like the recoilless rifles. If you zoom in, you can see that there's 2 guys at that. That's basically like a little artillery shell that they fire off their shoulder. The healing tent, by the way, sorry, the triage center, is a great investment if you're mostly infantry. A lot of players get that right off the bat. You'll see that he spent his first 60 fuel on the Browning automatic rifle upgrade for his rifleman, and then he spent the next fuel on his triage center. And then finally, a supply yard. You'd think most people, you know, think, oh, if I want vehicles, I'm going to skip all that and spend my fuel. But no, you get so much early game control by doing that. So just taking a look around here, and here we have our first Puma armored car, and you see it bumps into the airborne player, who's taking a little bit of casualty, but he's got the recoilless rifles, and unfortunately that second shot didn't do much damage, but that Puma has to get out of there, because this is very, very anti-vehicle. Anti-vehicle unit here, and this is exactly why people play armored versus this kind of a build order. Sorry, not armored, airborne against this kind of build order. Meanwhile, we'll see that there was a little